system and then do an answer.
Yeah, I say you start.
Okay. You can see the pool, so there is nothing to stand for that. This is a filter system. The yellow things, that's the filter system for the main, for the pool, actually. The green thing is a fishing system for those towers and the floor jets.
Okay.
So, this pump has to be on all the time.
Right.
So it can grab the water from the pool, send it to these yellow things, yellow pipes.
Right.
This is the pump with the basket. That's called the yellow extractor. And that's ready for the biggest thing, like the air, dirt, plastic, rocks, whatever.
Right.
And stay over there. So, pump is discharging that water through those filters. There is a sand inside. Our layer of the sand, the gravel, so all the water is coming from the top end to the layer of the sand, getting filtered, all the small debris stays inside that sand. We have clean water running from the bottom, so that's that's a river pipe.
Right.
And it's going all the way back to the pool. The difference this one is that we have a UV unit. This chamber with a UV light bulb inside that's burning all the bacteria and all the small things before the water comes back. So, from that return line, water is coming all the way to the UV unit, getting burned, getting clean, and going back. This line to the heater. So this is a bypass line. So this valve has to be closed all the way, all the time.
Okay.
The only thing that you need to open it is if you need to work something. This one, so you go with this one, and then you open this and then the water ran through and then going into the UV chamber.
Okay.
Same thing we have with the heater too. This is the bypass. You are fine about in here. Right now it's halfway open.
Right.
So you gotta keep it like that because that heater is not built so it can stand all four rings from the system. So some of the water is going straight back to the pool and some of the water is going inside and get heated, and then going back up. I'm not familiar with this type of heater because it's not provided by us. But it's the same like every other heater. Gas operating with a flame inside, those flames like barbecue. I'm heating the water, there is a disclaimer from inside,
yeah.
And the temperature is preset on like 87, 79, something like that.
Exactly.
So it does the water temperature right now.
Right.
Also, you have two separate temperature gauges here that are measuring the inside influence of the water and the effect of the water going right back.
So right now,
it's pretty much the same.
Okay.
So that's a basic thing. Also, we have two separate temperature sensors here and they are working like a backup. So if the water gets overheated, they're gonna shut down.
Okay.
One in this corner and the other one over there. One on the influent line and one on the gap.
Alright.
Also there is a flow meter over there. So on that thing you can check the flow rate of the water. And also we have a data sheet on the wall, so you can always check the direction and make sure that there is
no problem.
These two temp pressure gauges on the filter tanks show you how big the pressure is inside the tanks. So it's pretty much around 15 when everything is okay. When the sand, where the sand inside, getting hot, so it's not filtering the water anymore. Pressure is going to rise. So whenever it's low reverse, yes. So the water is going to run from the bottom to the top of the filter, get everything that's stuck on the sand, getting out, and brings it through the bag wash line. That's a black one. Over there, right into that thing. Yes.
So when I reverse it, where do I reverse it?
Also, we have those provided on the wall, but let me show you. First of all, you have to turn off the pump.
Okay.
We have two separate main switches for the pump.
Okay.
I don't know why two, because of some electrical problem. But one is here.
Right.
This is full pump. This is for the main, for the filtering system.
Okay.
This one is for the pitching system.
Okay.
I wrote this down, so that's the most important thing. Before you turn off the pump, turn off the UV.
Okay.
Otherwise, there is some problem that UV bulb is going to melt that chamber. And that's an expensive fix.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to cause a lot of problems.
Mm-hmm.
So, we're going to go to that later. You need to let me show you the other set of the switches.
This
UV bulb by itself is like $1,000. Only that. So this is the second set.
Okay. So turn this one off and that one off.
If you turn this one off, it's going to turn off. And this is on right now, but the other one is on. So you just need to leave that.
So this is sort of control.
Yes, they're connected together somehow. But if you want to run everything, this one has to be on and that one has to be on also. But like I said, I put the label in here. We're gonna print a nice label, laminated. You saw it's gonna be visible for everyone. So when you're doing the back wash, like I said before, water is including discharge line.
However,
this valve is open, so it allows water to go from the top to the filters. Also, in here, this is a backwash valve. So it's closed right now. So the water is stopping here, going inside, on the back, on the bottom. All the valves are labeled,
right,
with the numbers. So you have an instruction over there, but I'm
not. Okay.
So the water is coming down, like we said before. The first valve over there is closed right now.
Right.
But this one is open, so it allows the water to go through the line. When you're doing a bed wash, you just need to reverse all the valves. So that means you're closing the first one, turning off the pump.
Hello.
Hello. And then turn the pump
on. Right.
Close this one.
Okay.
And open this one that way. Water is going to be going through the bottom, through the bottom of the filter, going up. This one is closed, so it cannot run here.
Okay.
You're closing this one, so the water gets stuck to that line, going from the bottom, and you're opening this one.
Mm-hmm.
So the water is running from the bottom to the top, getting all the breeze out and into the back wash line.
Okay.
Pretty much the back wash line is called the back. It's supposed to last like maybe 1 minute.
Oh, right.
Not more than that. You can check the water over there. It's brown. The color is brown.
Okay.
As long as you see a clear water coming out, so that's it.
Okay.
Well,
brown and clear.
Of course. Then, turn off the pump again. Put all the valves like they're supposed to be for the filtering.
Right.
And turn off on the pump again.
Okay.
The blue line is fresh water filling.
Okay.
So this is a hand valve that should be open.
Right.
This is solenoid valve that is electrical control valve.
Okay.
Like this box, and this supposed to be on the switch.
Okay.
And we have a sensor in here that's measuring the water level. So when you're doing a back wash, you're sucking some water from the pool,
right,
and you're dumping it into the drain.
Right.
So the water level is going to go down a little bit.
Right.
So that's, this sensor in here is going to measure that, and when the water level is down, and it's fresh water. Put a little pipe inside of the pool, fill it up to a certain level, and the sensor is gonna turn off the water. Pretty much simple.
The pH level, we do all this, it's changing and stuff like that.
Of course. Whenever you put the pressure water inside, the shaking level of the water will change. That's the other problem, so we're gonna go to that.
Okay.
UV panel. So it's off right now. Always, when you turn on the pump, actually turn off the UV units first and turn off the pump. It's gonna need like 6 minutes for the UV bulb to get warmed down, to get cooled.
Cool down?
Yes, cool down. Right. So just leave it like 5 or 6 minutes, just give that time to the UV bulb to get cooled down,
right.
And then start to do whatever you need.
Okay.
When you turn it on, let me show you. It's simple. On and off, like on every pump. You don't need to know anything about this because it's complicated. I just provide you. If you wanted to, we have an operation and maintenance manual in here, so you can learn everything about that in this binder. I'm gonna keep it in here for now.
Alright.
So, when you start it on, it's on right now. So you see, it says warming.
Right.
So it's gonna need like 5 to 6 minutes, something like that, to get warmed up and to start working properly. So the most important thing is for you guys to remember, when the light bulb is working, we have fresh water running through the chamber and cooling down that light bulb.
Of course.
If we don't have that, the light bulb is gonna burn out.
Yep.
We have some temperature sensors on that UV chamber.
Okay.
That's supposed to turn off the light bulb if they measure a high temperature. That happened like 10 days ago. When the guys put those extra switches over there, they didn't turn on the pump. But the light bulb, the UV unit stays on. So it's, those sensors turn it off, unfortunately. But you can never count on that 100%.
Right.
So, most important thing, always, always turn off the UV unit first, and then do whatever you need to.
Right.
And never turn it back on before you turn the pump.
Right.
Before you have a water running through the system.
Water on first, then turn it back on.
And be sure that water is running through the system.
Right.
So you can check that on the flow meter.
Right.
Same thing with the...
Because when you do the backwash, does that flow meter drop?
Yeah,
now you got
yes, that flow meter gotcha. Going to drop because no water is going to go through that pipe.
Okay.
Picture pump, picture system is simple. No filters, no nothing. It's just grabbing water from the pool and running all the water to those picture towers and the floor jets. So these are the valves for the floor bubbles. And these are for the tower.
Shower shaft.
Yes.
Okay.
They're supposed to be adjusted, like I said, because if they hold the whole pressure in here, it's gonna spray all the way
everywhere.
Around. Because those towers are built like that. It's not up to us. So they need to be pretty much like this.
Okay.
Almost closed. We can adjust them later.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You will see. Turn on the pump, just wait for the pump to suck in the water,
right.
So you can always hear and see through that glass the water that is running inside. Also over there.
17. First of all, if you look at the clock, I would say 17. Looking at the clock. Yeah. Yeah. 17.
Also, I forgot to tell you that whenever you are doing a backwash, you're supposed to open that lid, take the basket out, and clean everything.
Okay.
Also, with that.
So when you do the back.
When you do the back wall, and that means when you're doing the back wall, first of all, open the lid, take the basket off, clean everything. You see that there are some rocks inside right now.
Oh, yeah.
There's gonna always be something inside.
Okay.
Because the pump is like the water through the maintenance, through the skimmer, so
right.
If there is in the pool, you're gonna always find something.
Okay.
At least some of those things with the hair.
Right.
Whatever this
is,
yeah, rubber bands and or something like that.
Yeah.
That thing is always going to get stuck.
Okay.
You see those tubings that run inside of the Wi-Fi part. Those are tubings to them. Yes. Those two are for the chemicals, the chlorine and the acid feeder. And the first one. Is for the cat controller. First one and the last one over there on the, for the yellow light.
Right.
For the light. For the cat controller. You see the beeping sound right now?
Yeah.
That beeping sound is coming from that cat controller. That's the thing that's measuring the chemical levels inside. Right now it's beeping, so that's mean alarm. Something is not okay. That is not a problem. Those two lines that are the controllers are measuring the chemistry inside and showing you how it is. You see in here, water running inside to this pipe, going through those, that system. We have two sensors in here. This one is for pH, this one is for ORP or measuring the chlorine level and all the other chemical balances and getting out, so you can always see when it's working. It's showing on this propeller, whatever, and going back. So right now the pH level is not okay. It's sounding alarm, you see. And that's mean the pH level is up. pH level is supposed to be 7.4. Right now it's 8.4.
And that's even that, even with children getting in there, it's still want to be at 7.4,
yes.
That's the ideal.
Yeah, it's supposed to be in between 7.2 and 7.8. It's not a problem if it's like this one, but you don't need to, you cannot allow it to go higher. The ORP level is okay right now. It's supposed to be between 625 and 825, so it's 725 right now, so it's
625 and 825?
625 to 825, 850, so that's probably like something like that. So it's 725 right now and it's okay. So inside of this, chemical, this is a chlorine feeder. We have chlorine in that bucket in here and it's almost empty, so we're going to provide it with another one. But you guys are supposed to have big tanks, like 100 gallon, okay, or 200, I don't know, the big tanks. So we've just put this small one to maintain the chemical levels right now. We're supposed to have big tanks. I don't know who's supposed to provide that. Probably you guys. So this is a chlorine feeder. When the
so we need to have that big tank before the children start.
Yeah.
Coming.
Yeah. It's going to be much easier than replace those small, this is like 10 gallons.
Is that 100 gallons in the normal?
Yeah. So when the cat controller measures that chlorine level is low, it's automatically turned on the chlorine feeder and it's going to...